We'll do this the Viking way then.
Your end is in our.
Cost you? I'll stage your welcome.
Soldiers' barracks. Others with might be here.
Go, Sunan.
Up in the fodder. kept a bargain?
If I slit a bullet...
Getting tired?
We keep on... My turn!
With me, here!
Hard to get through that door without being seen.
Hey! God
won't
let us lose! You three, scurry. Lady Athelswith, I see Burgred has done his best to hide you away. But what is lost must always be found.
Let my handmaidens walk free of this place. They have nothing to do with our quarrel.
You hear that, Eivor? Noble. Selfless. This is the sword you must strike a bargain with. A woman of quality. We seek only your king, lady. Tell us where Burgred hides, and we will leave without an ounce of blood spilled.
Please, I don't know.
Effective, Sigurd.
She is only naive to her present danger, but she will soon understand.
Wait. Those are the hands of one who washes linens. A servant. She is a decoy.
Watch the handmaidens. I'll follow Athelswith.
Aid me.
Don't scamper for free this time! Doctor! Your doom comes!
Not for that!
Eivor!
Run up the sail!
Siegler!
Bring the sail in!
Siegler!
Me. My husband will send you all to hell.
Quite clever, your ladyship. You're certainly making us work for it.
Keep your hands off me, pagan!
Have you lost your sense of hospitality? I regret asking. After what you put me through, I would have to be mad.
Do you understand what you're doing, pagan? I am the Lady of Mercia. You're wasting your time. I won't talk. Not to you, not to any of you barbarians.
You may reconsider, if only for your people. Who knows how many more might die at the hands of us barbarians.
You don't frighten me.
Then you are a fool.
Lady Otherswith, you have seen better days.
God will sear your soul, heathen, if he can find it.
Why, the cat, Eivor? She is as much a poet as you.
Where's my Catelyn? What have you done with her?
Your handmaiden, you mean? The brave one, dressed in royal finery? Season change with the others.
I'll take them back to Tamworth. Get them talking.
If she has so much as a scratch on her...
I will inform Ceolwulf. He might have some ideas on how to get through to her.
I will meet you there. Sigurd, what about these prisoners?
We've got what we need. Let them go.
Thor lends me strength.
Sing, my ravens. You salt scald, got a story?
I knew a crazed man about my age called Rokur. We had taken to calling Rokur the Rodent for his habit of collecting axes. For 20 years he collected axes of all make and size. He had never seen a day of battle, but he swore to Thor that he would. In his 31st year, after drinking too much ale, Rokur seduced another man's wife. That man called a holmgang against Rokur. Rokur accepted the holmgang, and on the agreed-upon day, he laid out 12 of his axes and asked, "Which of these will I use to slay you? Will it be Bone Splitter?" He said, "My bearded blade inscribed with Sather runes, affixed to a handle of English oak, or Blood Fountain," he continued. "My Dane axe, which swings through the air on two hands with the speed of an arrow's flight. Or might it be Twin Wolf Wounder?" Rokur growled, growing even more bold. "A fierce pair of throwing axes." At that moment, the man who had challenged Rokur brought a large stone down upon his head. Roker died instantly, and his axes were given away as gifts.
We'll pick up from there.
Hey, boy!
What does Hjaldik?
See you, old friend.
It's the Danes. It's always the damn Danes. Make them pay Vergjald for the dead that now litter the fields. Yeah!
Show sense, please. What would the Danes gain from the slaughter of poor farmers?
Look! There's a filthy Dane now. Why don't we ask?
Hey, Thomas!
You slaughtered my best milk cow, you beast!
I did not touch your herd.
You fools are making this worse.
These Saxons fight like mad dogs to protect their own. I cannot blame them.
Thank you for staying your hand, stranger. What is your name?
Eivor, of the Raven Clan in Mercia.
Wolfhilda, Abbess of Barking, and inquirer into mysteries.
Are we here for the same reason, I wonder?
Aye, to look upon devil's work. But why would a Dane from upriver care what happens to Saxon farmers?
If there's a rabid wolf or bear on the prowl, I would see it dead. Blame often falls on my folk for such carnage.
Well and good, Eivor of the Raven Clan. Take a look at the moorlings, and tell me what manner of rabid beast did these things.
I could start with the dead cows. You there, what befell this poor beast?
Danes befell it.
How can you be sure?
It was Hrothgar's warband. They're holed up in that old church. working their misery upon us.
Warriors do not often go about slaying milk cows. Besides, I have heard talk of a beast on the loose. Show me what lies ahead. Blood still wet as dew. Where does it lead? Bite marks, but not from any beast, I know. And the corpse is covered in strange mold, though the wounds are fresh. You are brave ones for getting so close to this awful sight.
I saw it, warrior. I did. The night it happened, I saw it all.
What did you see? A wolf? A bear? Maybe a rabid hound?
It was a Jotun, as straight as a tree. And it laughed while it ripped and teared. It yelled out its name. Drendel. A Jotun did this. I saw it. All big and hairy, staggering across the moor.
Giants aren't real. You saw the devil himself taking his tithe to hell.
By the gods. What manner of beast flung that poor creature up here to its doom? What sort of beast leaves glistening mold over freshly killed prey?
Yet that woman blamed the Hrothgar, his band of Danes, when he kills men.
Whoever it was, they were mighty enough to get a mauled beast corpse onto a rooftop. That little girl said the creature was a giant, calling itself Grendel. This may be the work of a band of drunken Danes. Or far worse. I should discuss these clues with Wolfhilda. Wolfhilda, I have learned all I can from the villagers and those dead beasts.
And what is your take on the mystery? Still believe a wolf or bear did these things?
This is not the work of a woodland creature. The bite marks, the mold, most art.
So you admit this is the devil's work? Or one of your wooden dragons come to life?
A few maulings do not make for a devil or a dragon. It must be a man, or a pack of them. The girl mentioned a name, Grendel.
No. No mortal hand could rend flesh in such a way. Surely you see that.
I have seen the worst the hands of men can do. Deeds bloodier than this.
And these men stalk the night, slaying cattle as they go.
True. This thing I cannot explain.
3 times these attacks have happened. Each time, bite marks, broken bones, and streaks of mold. Something wicked walks in East Anglia. Some other animals were attacked in the woods northeast of here.
Let us go.
This way. We may find more clues. Should be up there in the trees ahead. Can you smell it? It reeks of death and evil.
I know that scent well. Carrion and death. Loki's reek.
Saints! Save!
Let's move along.
Did the wolves get a bite of you?
No. I'm unhurt. Thank you, Thane. I misjudged you.
No need. But tell me what happened.
These beasts came scavenging for fresh meat.
I meant, why are you out here with the dead cattle again?
I'm searching for my best milch cow. She's missing.
And you found her?
No. But I found a Danish axe. It belongs to Hrothgar, leader of the warband.
You know for a fact this axe is his?
Yes. He brandishes it about the village, demanding ale.
I will speak to this Hrothgar and his warband.
That woman is certain a nearby band of warriors caused these maulings. We have no other clues.
I know the men she means. They're staying at the church near Brisleek Farm. Come, meet them. Their leader, Hrothgar, is a great man, for a heathen. He is no cattle killer.
You have curious opinions, Wilhilda, and an uncommonly open mind.
I should say the same of you. Most heathens would point to witchcraft or monsters, but you seek an earthly cause.
I have seen many strange things, but the answers are usually close at hand, if only hidden.
True. Yet in this case, the church has tasked me to explain the unexplainable. That, at times, introduces unholy ideas.
And your church accepts your unholy ideas?
They tolerate it. Lucifer is a deceiver, and God himself works in mysterious ways. So I, too, must remain open to all possibilities, mundane and otherworldly.
Which is why you tolerate a heathen like me.
Perhaps. Or perhaps all of us, heathen and Christian, stand within the folds of a greater mystery. Something's off, Eivor. Hrothgar's men are rowdy sorts, but the air is far too still.
Stand back, priestess. This is war work.
Hrothgar and his men,
Thunin. Killer may yet linger here.
Their leader, Hrothgar. I do not see him among the dead.
I shall find him. See, more fresh mold. Same as in the fields on the Kaas.
The villagers say it is the devil's mark. What do you say, Eivor?
I say find the mold, we find our killer.
Eivor, look up. More blood.
Someone crawled into the loft, or dragged the body up there.
I can still draw blood.
You are Hrothgar, leader of this warband.
I am. A Finnmark raider and proud of it. For the little time I have left.
I bear ill news. Your warriors have fallen. Who or what did this awful thing?
The monster did this thing. It killed us while laughing. laughing. It broke my axe and gouged me. I crawled up here to die.
What was it? Did you see?
A foul Jotun. A nightgoer from the world's rim. It spoke. Named itself Grendel. Said it would return.
Good. We shall wait for it to come back, you and I.
Not I. My wounds are too great and my spirit takes ship. Send them to Helheim. For me.
Ride with the winged women, friend. I will handle this Grendel, whatever manner of monster it may be.
Wait, warrior. There were two.
Best hide, to not scare the demon off when it returns.
We will wait up here for it to show itself again.
Get your rest, warrior. I will stand vigil with prayer.
To play. You make Grendel hurt. Mama, I want to go home.
By all that is holy and bright, what manner of monster is that thing?
Not a monster, but a man. Strange to behold, but this Grendel was a man.
But where did it come from?
All men have mothers. This one called out for his in the end.
And all of us, even the most hideous, have souls. Oh Lord, forgive this man his sins. And grant unto him your grace and everlasting love.
Mold everywhere. Stay here, Mufilda. I'll follow this trail.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May all their souls rest in peace.
Grendel must have tracked this mold here, but from where? More mold. I'm on the right path. I feel the source of the mold must be near. Into this pit. Speaks of her child, Grendel. Cruel fate the gods have woven.
What? Dark spirits torment this land. About the Danes.
To protect my boy. He never meant to hurt anyone. But the others, they could not see. He kept growing in body, but not in mind. He was my boy. Sweet little Brenda.
What killed them must know the truth of this.
Abbas.
Eivor, you live yet. Pray, tell all.
I slew a monster that was but a man. Then I tracked his mother and killed her too.
His mother?
She struck at me in the dark and I defended myself. But it was no hero's deed.
Those poor souls. I shall pray for them tonight at Barking Abbey.
Leaving already?
I must. The bishop is eager for a full accounting of the Beast of East Anglia.
Leave my name out of your tale. It is nothing to be remembered for.
Understood. Perhaps it would work better as a song. I dabbled in verse as a youth. It may be time to lift the pen again. But what story shall I write? The full truth of this thing may be hard to fathom.
Give them a comforting one, about heroes and monsters. For the truth, the bone-cold truth of everything is often hard to take. It cuts like a cruel north wind on the neck.
God saves us all, Eivor. I take my leave now, but will write to you once my poem is complete. Farewell.
Thank you, and farewell to you too, Wulfilda. Make it a good tale.
Ha! Survey the area, Sudan.
No!
All of these men of God, festooned in gold and silver.
It is enough to make one blind.
We are blind of now. Lanius was our only king. He saw straight and fought alongside Arturius. We have been blind ever since.
Huh?
Hello there. One of my better pieces. I hope to see you again soon.
I must take my leave. So long.
Some Godspell then, Papa and Onru.
Good you came by, Eivor. There are interesting requests today.
Angels and Miss Elitia Yestreon.
It's Wayne that Hion Knoa or a Langs from a Chipum. Each hour on Hira Witche, we have Clamatius.
They're always looking for help, so come back anytime.
Faren und Frong kamvene ich, ak unjelitches, hesok te chept ehida, de gode esindun nestrum landum.
Ne likjas me sexuru, ne ich ne.